Hi guys, welcome back. Thanks so much for joining in and being here today. We're gonna jump right into the video. I'm gonna be sharing 7 things I've learned over the past year that has helped me reach to the point where I am today, where I have over 1 million following. I make a full-time living off of being a content creator. As a matter of fact, my whole family works with me, which I'm so grateful for and so thankful for. But to get to this point, I've learned so many things, and I want to share them with you today. So hopefully, you know, maybe it may help you in some type, form, or fashion, or maybe you just actually need to hear this from somebody. Before I begin, hi, my name is Angel. If you have not subscribed, be sure to go ahead and join me here on this channel where I share behind the scenes of being a content creator so that you can grow and learn with me and from me. Lesson number one, there is a time and a season for everything, and everything is not meant to last forever. That means sometimes you have to walk away when you need to. You have to change and just have that mindset that, you know, everything is not meant to last forever. That could be a platform, you know, like MySpace is not around anymore. It's like, what is MySpace? But I was on MySpace, okay? Believe it or not. But that's just with every aspect of my life and especially my business. For instance, with brand deals, I'm to the point where I'm tired of doing brand deals. And I've talked about that so many times on this channel for so many different reasons, but you guys can go back and watch some of those previous videos if you want to know why or know more. Want picking up brand deals to be more of an option for financial survival than having to pick up some just to pay bills and get by. I already turned down literally about 90% of brands that come my way. I still have to pick up a few here and there just, you know, to pay bills, because honestly, brand deals can be a content creator's or influencer's bread and butter. And yes, I could make a ton from brand deals if I really wanted to. And I can definitely teach you guys how to land brand deals if that's for you. And I've already done some videos out there, so you can definitely check those out. I've grown to the point where I don't want my number one source of income to be from brand deals. Which leads me to lesson number two. Passive income is my ultimate goal, which would equal less work, unlimited income, and pretty much more sleep, because you can make money while you sleep. If you don't know what I mean when I say passive income, because there are two forms of income. You have passive income and you have active income. Active income is income you have to actively work towards to gain income. So in essence, you know, when you work at a job and get a hourly salary or yearly salary, you have to go in, punch in the clock, be to work, get those hours to get an income. So you have to actively put that time in to get a check. Whereas passive income, you don't necessarily have to punch a clock. You don't have to make sure to hit in a certain amount of hours or be there physically, mentally, emotionally. You don't have to be there. Passive income is money that comes in when you don't have to actively work for it, which could be in so many forms. I've done some videos on passive income, but to just throw out a few, you know, if you have investments and you get your dividends, that's just money that comes in. You're not doing anything. You're not out there, you know, hustling for the company and making sure the company is doing what they're supposed to do. Dividends just come in as the company grows and makes money. So that's passive, because you don't have to do anything. You just go ahead and invest in whatever you want to invest in, and you know, money just comes in while you're sleeping. There's so many forms. There's digital products. It's a form of passive income, which I already have some of those sources set up, and I'll actually plan on coming and doing a more in detail video about how I make money with my digital products. In addition, affiliate marketing can become a source of passive income too, depending on how you market it and how you put it out there. But it definitely can become a source of passive income too. Once you put the work out there once, it can make unlimited income in the future. I'm gonna come do more in detail videos about that. Also, I've done some in the past, and I'll throw those out there if you guys are interested in checking those out, but I will come back and go more into detail and give you some more examples of how that works for me. But that is my second lesson that I've learned, and is something that I've grown to, and I have become more self-aware of where I'm at, how I'm feeling. Lesson number three is to invest in yourself. Guys, hear me when I tell you this. Money is a tool. Do not be afraid to use it, to invest in yourself. And that means using money to get and live the life that you want. Now, for those who may not know me, those who know me already know this, but a lot of you guys may not really know me. I am a stingy person. I like to save money. I don't like to spend on certain things. I do like to shop, but I love to save. I really don't go to salons. I haven't been to a hair salon, a nail salon, any type of salon in, oh my God, years and years and years. Because I just do it myself and save my money, or I spend my money in other ways. And one aspect of that is I spend in my business. I invest in myself. I will easily spend money on something that's going to help me in the long run. Whether it's ads and promotions, workshops, courses, equipment, software, the list goes on. I will definitely drop money on something that is going to help me in the long run and in the future and help me to make more money. Money is a tool. You know how you use a tool to build furniture? You need a tool to build furniture, right? You buy the tool, but that tool is helping you create something bigger. Same with money. Don't be afraid to use it, and don't always want stuff for free, because when you actually take it and use it in a way that's going to benefit you in the future, just because you spent some now, you're going to make more in the future. It's for a bigger purpose and a bigger project. And you're putting it actually back into you, and it's not going down the trash. So whether it's put money in ads for your products or for exposure to grow your channel or whatever it is, don't be afraid to use the money. Don't be afraid to buy a course. Don't be afraid to get a workshop. Guys, alert. I have spent thousands on courses and workshops and learning in general. I have spent thousands on equipment, okay? I got a ton of software. So, you know, it kills me when people always want stuff for free. And I'm like, I have not grown to the point where I am by not spending a dime, to be quite frank. I'm gonna hit on that more later. But the main thing right now is money is a tool. Don't be afraid to use it. Be willing to invest in yourself. Tip number 4, create your own happiness. This is definitely a model that I live by and a quote that I live by. And I've had this in me and ingrained in me for a long time. And I always promote this quote. And what that really means is to set your goals that you want to achieve, your vision of how you're going to get there, and then work to achieve it. A lot of people drop that ball when it comes to working to achieve it and to follow through. We always set goals. I want to be a YouTuber, but it's much bigger than just sitting here saying, I want to be a YouTuber. You have to set goals, set visions, and then actively work towards that vision. Whatever your vision is, if it's the vision of a good life or well-balanced life or a certain type of career, if you want to become an influencer, you can create your own happiness. And honestly, I can't tell you what motivates you or the type of lifestyle you want to create. Only you can create your own happiness. But if you need help or guidance, I can help guide you. I do have a Create Your Happiness starter kit out there, you guys. I actually created that for myself and talk about it more on my lifestyle channel, Angel Grace Jew. But you know, if you're to that point where you're trying to figure out how to create your own happiness and you need a little bit of a booster or help or some guidance, you can grab that journal. It will help you get started, because having a vision is important, and you can set goals all year long. You can come January and set your new year goals. All of that is cool and dandy. Having a vision is important, but you need benchmarks, milestones, and you have got to measure your progress and actively work towards it. When you're actively working towards it, it's easy to measure your goals. How far along are you? How are you getting there? You want to be clear about what you want to achieve, but you also want to be flexible enough about how you're going to get there. On this channel, I actually shared my business goals with you guys for 2021, and I am actually conquering them little by little, and I share that. You guys can check that out if you're interested or you want to know. Just remember, you create your own happiness for the most part. I mean, yes, we always have stuff out of our control and, you know, nature and God and all of that, but you can create your own happiness by setting your goals, getting your vision together, and actively working towards it. And that's what I mean when I say create your own happiness. Lesson number 5, find the people that see the greatness in you. Believe it or not, everyone in your life is not going to be there to support you. You have to be okay with outgrowing people. Like the old saying goes, always won't open new doors. And old friends won't get to new ends. So that's really just, it's meaning to find people who speak life over you, who grow with you, who supports you, who always encourages you to be the best and is not concerned with you being better than them. And those people are hard to come by. So that's a great lesson to remember and to keep in mind and to learn from, because people are gonna be there to deter you, and you're gonna have to not be able to listen to what others say. And this may sound harsh, but let me tell you, once you've gotten your vision together, don't give a flying flip about what anybody else has to say or what they think. Now, that is a caveat, because if you're married and have a spouse, you know, you have to work together. You can't just jump off the bridge and do what you want to do. That's different. But what I'm saying is, you're going to have negative people out there that try to deter you from a dream, tell you you can't do it, or you don't need to do that, or why are you doing that? Because I kid you not, people looked at me crazy and asked me all kind of crazy questions, like, why are you leaving law for social media? Like, it happened all the time. Like, I got the craziest of the craziest looks, and people talked about me behind my back. It's okay, though. It's all right, because I was not listening to them. People will be quick to judge you, family and friends included, okay? Those are probably the number ones that's going to judge you. But you have to learn to ignore most of the chatter and stay focused. Only put your time and energy into those who speak life over you and support you. And then on top of this whole people thing, don't let people use you. People will definitely try and want to use you. Don't let people use you. Family and friends included, and mostly, honestly. Moving on. Lesson number 6. Never stop learning or relearning. Learn from your experts in your industry. Here's a big tip. If you didn't know this, here's something for you. You will never be the smartest person. There is always somebody out there smarter than you, know more than you, somebody you can learn something from. On top of that, things change, algorithms change. There's always something to learn or relearn. Like I was saying earlier, I've spent thousands in education, in courses, in workshops. Why not? I say it like this. Why waste my time? If someone has figured out how to do something and how to do it quicker, then I'm all for it. Why waste years to get there and make tons of mistakes when you can learn from others and get there quicker? Remember, educators have made the mistakes and have figured out the tips to success after years of testing. So, take the easy way out. Pay for the course. People can contribute to you in so many different ways, whether it's time, knowledge, presence. Find people who's at the top of your industry and learn from them. And then work on building your own. Look, I'm always learning something new. I have to always keep up with the algorithm changes. I mean, that's constantly, and that's always, you know, learning and relearning. And then I always love to learn how to improve my content. I always critique myself and figure out ways I can improve here or there. Like now, y'all hear my new mic? I got a new mic, what? Yeah, I always try to find ways to improve. So yeah, never stop learning or relearning. All right, lesson number 7, analyze, critique, and pivots. Those 3 things in one sentence. Track what's working, what's not working, what you need to change, and what you need to keep the same. Everything in your business is tweakable. Always take note as you grow. Not only will it help you as you look back, but you'll be able to create a blueprint that could help others. Look, many people will pay you just to know what not to do, okay? So making the mistakes is a great thing, actually. It's a learning lesson. They'll pay you just as much to learn that, just as they would to pay you what to do, you know? Because you need to know what not to do also. Those setbacks can be someone else's step up and their stepping stone. Let me just say, everything is always evolving and evolving, okay? Nothing ever stays the same. What worked a year ago may not work now, you know? And that's true for a lot of social media platforms now. I can vouch for that. There may be new trends, new call to actions, new things people are comfortable with, new ways of presenting content. Everything is always evolving. Content is evolving. Your audience is evolving. What satisfied them yesterday may not satisfy them today. So always be open to analyzing, critiquing, and pivoting your business, yourself also. So those are my 7, I think, biggest lessons I have learned over time, and that's where I'm at. That's how I'm feeling. Maybe something sat well with you, even if something didn't sit well with you. You know, you can look at your life and give yourself a self audit and see what lessons you have learned, how you're feeling, and where you're growing and going. Pushing towards. So what's next? You guys, if you do want to learn from me about, you know, being an influencer and a content creator, I do have lots of free resources out there. You guys can check that down below in the description box. Don't forget, before you leave, make sure to give me this a thumbs up. I really, really do appreciate that, you guys. And drop me a comment and let me know some lessons that you learned. You know, everybody else can, you know, they may learn from you too. So drop a comment and let us know what lessons you learned, or maybe what tips that I gave, you know, resonated with you. I'd love to know. So I'll see you guys in my next video.